Hello, I'm Yves Marignac, spokesperson and head of prospective analysis of the négaWatt Association. We're starting a project for developing an ambitious European energy transition scenario, and we want to focus on energy sufficiency in this project.
My name is Tobias Fleischer. I'm working for the Fraunhofer Institute for Systems and Innovation Research in Germany, in Karlsruhe. One of the many things we do there is energy systems modeling, developing decarbonization pathways for individual sectors until 2050, and developing strategies for decarbonization.
I'm Anja Biedert, and I'm co-leader of the research unit Urban Transformation at the Wuppertal Institute for Climate, Environment and Energy in Germany. And yeah, we are focusing a lot on urban transformation regarding sustainability and have main interest in the interlinkages between ecologic and social and societal aspects.
My name is Philippe Beauvais. I'm leading the Swiss group négaWatt Switzerland. It's a brand new association. We were created 1 year ago. We're still very small, but we are very interested in developing a scenario including sufficiency.
I very much like the main idea of the project to evaluate sufficiency in the strategies and long-term decarbonization pathways, and to look at if not behavioral change could play a much stronger role in these pathways, especially as alternatives like new technologies or also the renovation of the building stock, etc., might not evolve as ambitious as we've seen in these scenarios so far. So we simply need to look at all the options, and sufficiency is one that is currently I think neglected, but so the project wants to look at that, and that's what I like very much.
Well, the history of sufficiency is quite long at the Wuppertal Institute. We're working on that subject for more than 20 years now. So we still want to come further and foster it and getting it into a political strategy and see it be included in policy making. So we can contribute parts of, like, in transportation we are working, we have some expertise in deep decarbonization in energy intensive industries, and with me being architect and environmental sciences, my personal interest are buildings and sufficiency policy for buildings.
It's very important for Switzerland to include sufficiency because we have different type of scenarios that have been done, but they never include sufficiency, or they put it in a special drawer with just a few lines saying it could be something important, but there's no real calculation about sufficiency connected with efficiency and ending with 100% renewable goal. It's also very important for Switzerland because Switzerland is a very rich country, and most of the people have the idea that Switzerland can simply buy the new technology and things will happen. And we have also some different high schools that are very orientated regarding or towards technology. So implementing or discussing sufficiency is a very important target for us.